Okay, now friends, we'll be starting with the exercise number 1.1, into which the first question states that is 0 a rational number? They're asking us, is 0 a rational number? Can it be expressed into p by q form, which is into the definition of rational number? That is, any number that could be expressed into p by q form, wherein p and q are integers and q is not equals to 0. Okay, following these conditions, can 0 be expressed into this form? Is what is the question being asked? Okay, so the answer for this is yes. 0 is a rational number. How? Can we write 0 as 0 by 1? It means the same, right? Is equals to 0 itself. Right? Where, if we go with the conditions, agar aap conditions ko dekho, to p and q should be integers. Is 0 an integer? Yes. Is 1 an integer? Yes. Both are integers. And the other condition being, the denominator q should not be equals to 0. So, kya ye 0 se equal hai? Nahi. So, both the conditions satisfied and 0 could be expressed into p by q form. So, yes. 0 is a rational number. Easy? Okay. Moving to the next example. Okay, so the next example is question number 2 into exercise number 1.1, which asks us to find 5 rational numbers between 3 and 4. We need to find 5 rational numbers between 3 and 4. As you all know, on the number line, between any two points, there are infinite points. Okay, so we are supposed to find at least 5 rational numbers between 3 and 4. Okay, so for solving this particular sum, we have two methods. Okay, I'll explain in detail both the methods. Aapko jo bhi convenient lage, easy lage, wo aap follow kar sakte. Theek hai? Starting with the first method, that is method number 1. Agar aapko 3 or 4 ke beech mein, you want to find 5 rational numbers. So, onto the number line, if these are 3 and 4, what if we find average of both? Okay, so if we find average of both, 3 plus 4 by 2 is equals to 7 by 2. So, average ki location kaha rehti hai? Beech mein, on the center, right? So, this is somewhere here located as 7 by 2. Okay, agar aap suppose lete ho average of 10 plus 5. तो क्या आता है आंसर 10 plus 5 by 2 15 by 2 तो कहां पे लोकेटेड होगा एट द सेंटर ऑफ 10 एंड 5 राइट दैट इज यू कैन इफ यू सिंपलीफाई दैट विल बी 12.5 तो दोनों के बीच में आ गया सिमिलरली हियर बिटवीन 3 एंड 4 इज 7 by 2 इसको आप डेसिमल में कन्वर्ट करोगे तो दैट विल बी 3.5 ओके सो दैट कम्स एग्जैक्टली अंडर द सेंटर सो दिस इज वन ऑफ द रैशनल नंबर दैट वी हैव फाउंड बिटवीन 3 एंड 4 We are yet to find more 4 rational numbers. Okay, what if we take average of this and this? Agar aap 7 by 2 and 4 ka average le lo. Okay, so kya answer aayega? If you take an LCM here of 2, that would be 7 plus 8 whole upon 2. Kitna aayega? 7 plus 8 goes as 15. Ye 2, 2 multiply ho jayega. So that is 15 by 4. Okay. This is the average of this two number. So again the funda goes the same way. Jiska bhi average hai uske beech mein ye number located hoga somewhere here going as 15 by 4. There's one more rational number between the two numbers 3 and 4. Huh? Aap condition bhi yaad rakhe jao rational number ki. That is p by q form mein hona chahiye. P by q both the integers and the denominator q not being 0. Okay, condition satisfied ho ye? Yes. Okay, next, in dono ka average le lete hain, would be 3 plus 7 by 2 whole upon 2. LCM le lete hain, kya aayega? 6 plus 7 whole upon 2 would be how much? 6 plus 7 is 13. Ye dono multipliers aayenge by 4. Theek? To wo hum kahan pe likhenge? Somewhere here. That is 13 by 4. Got it? So, these are the 3 rational numbers that we have found between the numbers 3 and 4. Okay, we are yet to find 2 more. तो आप किसका एवरेज लेंगे? यू कैन चूज एनी टू कॉम्बिनेशन. व्हाट इफ वी गो विद दिस टू नंबर्स 3 एंड 13 बाय 4? तो क्या आएगा? 3 प्लस 13 बाय 4 होल अपॉन 2. ये आ गया आपका एवरेज. ओके, एलसीएम ले लेते हैं 4 से, तो 4 इंटू 3 वुड बी 12 प्लस 13 होल अपॉन 4 बाय 2. 12 प्लस 13 कितना बनेगा? 25. 4 इंटू 2 वुड बी 8. This is the average of these two numbers. लिखेंगे कहाँ? इसके सेंटर में. That shall be 25 by 8. Good enough? Clear? It's simply about taking averages between the two numbers. अभी next average हम किसका ले लेंगे? 15 by 4 and 4 का. So क्या बनेगा? 15 by 4 plus 4 whole upon 2. और इसका आप LCM ले लो. 4 LCM रहेगा. तो 15 plus 4 into 4 would be how much? 16 by 4 whole upon 2 would be how much? 15 plus 16 is 31 by 4 into 2 would be 8. Got it? So this could be located on the number line somewhere here. Average of this 2, center of this 2, right? क्या लिखेंगे यहाँ पे? 31 by 8. Okay? So ये बन गए आपके 5 rational numbers between the numbers 3 and 4. This. And these are the 5 rational numbers. This is the method number 1 for solving this particular question. How about following the method number 2? Going with the method number 2. See, agar aapko 3 or 4 ke beech mein you want to find the 5 rational numbers. So, aapko kya karna hai? Jo bhi 2 numbers diye hain, unme se jo bhi chota hai, you need to write on the left hand side. The bigger number on the right hand side. Okay? देन आपको देखना है कितने रैशनल नंबर्स पूछ रहे हैं. यहाँ पे हमें पूछे हैं 5 रैशनल नंबर्स. सो मल्टीप्लाई दिस पर्टिकुलर नंबर विथ एनी नंबर हायर देन 5. ओके, सो व्हाट इफ यू सिलेक्ट 10, मल्टीप्लाई एंड डिवाइड. ओके, सो इनटू 10 अपॉन 10, सिमिलरली इनटू 10 अपॉन 10. ऑलराइट, सो अब क्या बनेगा ये? 30 बाय 10 एंड दिस विल बिकम 40 बाय 10. Now, as we want to find 5 rational numbers, now what the technique is, just to increase this digit by 1 and go on. Okay, so what shall that become as? 31 by 10, comma, 32 by 10, comma, 33 by 10, comma, 34 by 10, comma, 35 by 10. So, these are the numbers, 5 rational numbers ranging between 3 and 4. This number shall go on as 36 by 10, 37 by 10, but here we are just asked for 5 rational numbers. So, I have just stopped here, right? So, these are the two methods. These are the rational numbers. We got it with method 1 and these are the rational numbers. We got it with method 2 between 3 and 4. You can follow any method. इसमें क्या है कि सिर्फ LCM लेते वक्त आपको बिल्कुल ध्यान रखना पड़ेगा कि आपकी mistake ना हो while taking LCM. Otherwise, you can follow this method. This is, I think so, quite easy and could be finished faster. Right? So, this is how we can solve finding the rational numbers. Okay? Okay. Going with the third example, that is again about finding the rational numbers between two numbers. Now, the given two numbers here are again rational numbers. Okay? So, agar aapko do number diye yahan pe jo hai, wo hai 3 by 5 and 4 by 5. So, earlier sum mein I explained you the sum. जहां पे आपको 3 और 4 के बीच में 5 रैशनल नंबर ढूंढने थे, राइट? तो हमने दोनों मेथड्स देखी. मेथड 1 जिसमें हम एलसीएम लेते थे, एवरेज लेते थे, राइट? एंड द मेथड 2 जहां पे वी यूज टू मल्टीप्लाई एंड डिवाइड बाय नंबर ग्रेटर देन द नंबर, जितने भी आपको रैशनल नंबर फाइंड करना उससे ज्यादा वाला नंबर, राइट? सो वी कैन अप्लाई द सेकेंड मेथड ओवर हियर, जो यहाँ पे ज्यादा कन्वीनियंट रहेगी. सो व्हाट वी कैन डू इज वी कैन हियर मल्टीप्लाई एंड डिवाइड द बोथ द डिजिट्स नंबर्स बाय 10, अगेन बाय 10. क्या होगा? 3 बाय 5 इंटू 10 डिवाइड बाय 10 इंटू 10 डिवाइड बाय 10. ओके, सो क्या बनेगा ये नंबर? दिस विल गो एज 30 बाय 50 एंड दिस विल गो एज 40 बाय 50, राइट? सो अगेन, इफ यू विश टू फाइंड 5 रैशनल नंबर्स, यू नीड टू एड 1 टू each of this numerator, right? तो क्या बनेगा? 31 by 50, comma 32 by 50, comma 33 by 50, comma 34 by 50,
comma 35 by 50 and it shall go on. Right, if you want to find more. Here we are just asked to find 5 rational numbers. So we'll just go till 35 by 50. Okay, so I hope this is clear with you how to find rational numbers between the two given integers or maybe between two given other rational numbers. It's easy and you can easily crack the answers. Right, thank you. Okay guys, coming to the last question of the exercise 1.1, wherein there are certain statements, jisme aapko batana hai whether the statement is true or false and you need to justify your answer with a reason. Okay, reason wahi hoga jo aap example denge. Right, so going with the first statement that every natural number denoted by n is a whole number. इसके लिए यू शुड बी नोइंग व्हाट आर नेचुरल नंबर्स एंड व्हाट आर होल नंबर्स. जो हमने फर्स्ट लेक्चर में ऑलरेडी हम पढ़ चुके हैं, नेचुरल नंबर्स आर द नंबर्स स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम 1, 2, 3, 4 गोइंग अप टिल इंफिनिटी. व्हाट आर द होल नंबर्स? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 गोइंग अप टिल इंफिनिटी. ओके, तो ये सारे जो नेचुरल नंबर्स हैं क्या इसमें आ जाते हैं इनटू द होल नंबर्स? यस, सारे के सारे इंक्लूड हो जाते हैं. Right, so every natural number is a whole number. Can we say that? Yes, absolutely. So this statement is true. Fine, the first statement is true. Moving to the second statement, every integer is a whole number. Okay, every integer that is denoted by z is a whole number denoted by w. What are integers? From negative infinity going up till minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0. 1, 2, 3 going up to positive infinity. These are integers. Okay, whole number kya hote hai? Jo humne pehle bhi dekha. 0, 1, 2, 3 going up to infinity. Yahan pe kya keh rahe hain? Look, every integer is a whole number. Take an example. Suppose say minus 3 is an example. Okay, do you think minus 3 is a whole number? Include ho raha hai isme? No. So the statement here given is false. Right? Every integer is a whole number is a false statement. Isi cheez ko aap reverse dekhiye. Is every whole number an integer? Agar aapko ye statement diya jaye ki every whole number is an integer, to kya wo sahi hoga? Wo true hoga? Absolutely. Kyun? Kyunki yahan pe jo bhi numbers hai starting from 0, 1, 2, 3 going up to infinity, they are there into integer list also. So, ये सारे whole number integers में include हो रहे हैं, but सारे integers whole number में include नहीं हो रहे, right? So, this should be very clear if you know the definition of each of the category of numbers. And absolutely, मैंने जो आपको पहले भी flowchart बताया था, वो आप बिल्कुल याद रखिए, so that आपकी कभी भी mistake ना हो. उसमें क्या बताया था मैंने? रियल नंबर बींग द फादर ऑफ ऑल द नंबर्स, उसमें दो कैटेगरी आ जाएगी, योर रैशनल नंबर, योर इरैशनल नंबर. इनटू योर रैशनल नंबर विल कम व्हाट? द इंटीजर्स जेड. इनटू इंटीजर्स होल नंबर, इनटू होल नंबर द नेचुरल नंबर्स. इफ यू रिमेम्बर दिस पर्टिकुलर फ्लो चार्ट, ये वाले जो स्टेटमेंट्स है आपके ट्रू एंड फॉल्स के, वो कभी आपके रॉन्ग नहीं होंगे. ओके, natural number will be included, all the natural number will be included into whole number, all the whole number shall be included into integers, all the integers shall be included into rational numbers, including all rational and irrational numbers shall be included into real numbers. Okay, this is the flowchart you should be remembering for solving such questions. Fine, coming to the third statement, that is every rational number is a whole number. Every rational number is a whole number. कह सकते हैं क्या इसे हम? What is rational number? Number that could be represented into p by q form, where p and q are integers and q is not equal to 0. Okay, तो इसका मैं कोई example लूँ, say 3/2 is an example. Do you think this is included in the list of whole numbers? जो हमने यहाँ पे लिखा था उसमें include होगा? No. So this particular statement goes false. Fine. So this also being false. This is the first is true. So this is how we can solve the statements as true and false by giving an reasons. Reasons mein kya denge aap? Examples. Okay. So are you clear with this? We'll move with the further theory and exercises into next lecture.
राइट।